I'm standing here in front of the Collaborative Research Center at Rockefeller University. You can see over here on the right the old Smith building, which has been completely gutted and totally renovated into open laboratories. And here on the left, what's going to be called the Greenberg building that links the building to Flexner. It was funded very generously by Hank and Corinne Greenberg. Now, this project serves two aims. First of all, it updates some of the real estate on Rockefeller University's campus, which needs a lot of attention. These buildings were built 1915, 1925, and some areas had hardly been renovated since that time. But the second and maybe more important aspect of this is that it provides space which is designed for interaction and collaboration. Because here we are in Manhattan and we have a lot of vertical buildings, and those vertical buildings of course mean that there's a lot of isolation between laboratories because there's many different floors. Here we have the possibility of joining Smith and Flexner, which will give us, with this the Greenberg linking building, a much bigger footplate where we can get 6, 7, 8 laboratories on the same floor. The idea is that the arrangement of the floors are such that you're going to be able to see colleagues working on different floors, so you're not isolated on one particular floor. You can also see that there's lots of areas where you can sit and work, where you will walk into people or people will walk into you. And the whole idea of this space is to provide places where people will mix with other laboratories, where random collisions can take place, and where perhaps new good ideas will emerge. This is the floor where you enter into the Greenberg linking building, and one notable feature is you can see there's very open stairs, very attractive stairs, and they go all the way up the building. And this is to encourage people to actually walk from floor to floor rather than using the elevators. The majority of stairwells on the Rockefeller campus really serve as fire escapes. They're not attractive places to walk up and down. That isn't the case here. These are attractive, and researchers will walk up and down, and that will provide better opportunities for randomly meeting people. On each floor there's two meeting rooms, a large one which is on the corner of the building with great views over the East River, and a smaller one which is actually more towards the centre of the atrium. This larger room, which I'm sitting in here, is big enough to take at least 25 or 30, if not more, researchers, so is able to take the biggest research groups that we have on campus. It not only has whiteboards, but also a very large TV screen. And this means that you're not having to make the whole area dark, you don't have the complexities of blinds and the like. It means you can switch more easily from a presentation to a discussion, and maybe if you get a little bored, you can just look out of the window and look at the boats sailing by. This is one of the wings of Smith on the top floor, and you can see that these labs extend the entire length of the wing. Quite a few different bays with researchers working two to each bay, and so there's around 20 on each side of the building, with communal facilities there in the middle. And this provides many opportunities to run into different people. We'll have different labs actually occupying adjacent space, so again those sort of random collisions really matter. This is the coffee bar down on the bottom floor in the Greenberg connecting building. Not only is this a nice space to sit in, but out there, when all the building is done, it's going to be full of chairs and so on out here in that garden area, which is very, very nice. Once again, a great place to randomly meet people. It's more informal, as you can see here, than in the case of Weiss. And then down here on one floor below will be the new auditorium. And this is a really important addition to the campus as well. It'll be an auditorium that can take 200 to 250 individuals. You can see this taking over a heavy load of seminars now and lectures. Now, that will only be opened up in 2 years' time when Flexner is complete, because actually we're building Flexner from where the auditorium is located. In thinking about this building, quite a lot of attention was paid to green features. First of all, we used the old building. We didn't knock it down, and that already saves a great deal of resources. Attention was paid to the landscaping. These are really very nice gardens that have been added to the campus. And furthermore, this is actually a roof that I'm standing on here. And so this is a green roof, which is also a good thing. But there are many other numerous features that make it a green-friendly building. It will be LEED certified. That means that it will be recognised as a building that's been built thinking about green principles. Really a major centerpiece of the research strategy for the university. This building achieves this really successfully.